So is this Samsung deal as really as good as they said it was? We're gonna find out. Because when I bought that TV, I got that TV for free. And we're gonna see exactly how good this TV is. So stick around while I do an unboxing and a review of this television. So let's get to it. So back when Samsung first came out with their 2024 line of televisions, they offered a free 4K 65-inch television if you purchased one of the new 2024s. I believe there was some of the QLEDs and then of course the OLEDs. And so as we all know, I bought the S90D LED and I got this one for free. So I was gonna use this in one of my other bedrooms, but we decided not to. So it's just been sitting here in my office and I decided that I'm going to unbox it. We're gonna do a quick review and then I'm gonna actually connect it to my computer that's behind that television that's connected to my Elgato, and we're gonna check that out because I'm gonna use this as my streaming monitor slash TV. And yeah, this should be pretty epic. So you'll definitely wanna stick around and you'll definitely wanna hit that like and subscribe and that bell icon so you don't miss any content because there's gonna be some cool videos coming up. So let's get to it. All right, so let's see what we got inside here. All right, let's take this up, see what we got. Move this over here. Okay, nice. I do like the way they do their packaging in that they give you this big box that just slides up once you take the straps off. That way you don't have to worry about it falling over. And here it looks like we have the remote and our power cable. Set that there for now. And here are our two legs for the base. This off here. Of course, you gotta be very careful with all this foam because otherwise you get foam all over your floor. Looks like I got it backwards. Let me spin this around. All right, so nice foam protection for the screen. Now this TV here is 65 inch. That's a 55 inch, and I did 55 inch for my gaming TV intentionally, but I just want you to know, even though this is bigger, this TV is substantially heavier than that one, and it's much thicker and bulkier. It just goes to show you the technology that goes into these OLED TVs is amazing. And ready for the unveiling. Oh, well, that was very anticlimactic. Not what I was hoping for. Okay. Let's see, that's sitting on there, so I'm gonna have to lift that out. So I'll just put that flat on the floor here. All right. Now let's just lay this face down. We'll put the feet on it. Might be a little hard to see, but here's all our connections. And it does have an Ethernet port too, so I think I'll run another Ethernet cable from the switch over here and connect this to the internet as well. Looks like we have two HDMIs, digital, optic out, and USB. And so as you can see, they don't really give you the plethora of connection options like this TV here does. I have four HDMI 2.1 ports on here. I think these are 2.0. I don't know that they're 2.1, but we're gonna find out. All right, stick the bottom of this, put our feet in. So I'm not sure what that is. Oh, this is probably for the speakers right here, these holes, because the feet go here. Oh, it would help if I paid attention because that says right. So I need to put it in the correct hole because this hole here is labeled right. So that's probably why it wasn't fitting. I wouldn't have thought these would have a particular side, but I think it's because they're kind of like angled a little bit. So that's nice and firm. Set it back down. Get this out from under it. Put this over here. Well, there you have it. Now I'll take this plastic off the front of it. Again, I do like that they give you that to help protect the screen. I think what I want to do, I'm going to move this out here first. I do think I need to get a table or something to set it up on though. I don't know that I'm going to leave it on the ground, but that I'll probably have to resolve later. I don't think I have anything handy furniture wise to put it on, but we'll see. All right, so let's slide this down just a hair. So I just scooted all that down enough to be able to fit that between here and the table that's sitting on. So that's not too bad. Actually, I do have a table over here that I got my printer on that I'm not really using. And I think I'll move it over here and then I can set that on that table. And that'll pick that up off the ground because that's a little bit too low. But let's get this cover off. Let's get it powered on and let's check it out. Let's see what the screen looks like. The remote's not as nice as that other one either, but you know, look, it's free. Not complaining. It's definitely has a lot more options than the other one. I mean, look at all those buttons on here. That's crazy. You see that? Compared to that. I mean, that TV does a lot more than this TV does, but this TV remote requires some type of engineering degree and this one doesn't. So, let's see. I am gonna go ahead and get my Ethernet cable and get that connected to the network though. Now I can just tell like right off the bat, the way this TV looks as far as the blackness and the darkness of the screen, definitely way different than that. I have a SmartThings app, but it's on my phone and I'm using my phone to record, so I can't do that right now, but I will add it to the SmartThings because I have all my stuff connected to SmartThings. Let me take care of this first. So let's go ahead and just move on past that because we know it's not connected. Okay, that's great. Tab view, probably won't ever use that. Wow. Now I'll have to say that this color right here is pretty awesome considering. Baywatch. let's see. This remote, they give you a Samsung TV Plus button, which is their free television stuff. It's pretty, it's actually really good. It's really nice. It's kind of surprising the amount of channels and you get, you know, so much content for free. It's pretty crazy. All right, well, I'm just gonna leave it on that for right now. So let's take a look at these settings because I know I talked about having the ambient light sensor on and I don't really want that. I wanna set it to a particular brightness because that's what I like. So let's go into the settings. And I like how their menus are all the same on all their televisions. It's so easy to manage. No, I think that's it. Baywatch. So ridiculous. Yeah, you can't ever outdo the original, you know? I mean, that is the free TV you get when you bought one of the 2024 units. And in all reality, this would be a great television for like a kid's room or a spare bedroom or something like that. I don't know that I want to use it as my primary television because it doesn't really have quite the picture clarity that I like, but it definitely is not bad by any stretch of imagination. So I'd say that was a fantastic deal that Samsung gave everybody. So, all right, well, make sure you hit that like and subscribe and that bell icon because the next video we're getting this computer hooked up and that's gonna be a pretty awesome setup once everything's configured and we're gonna go over some Streamlabs setup and the Elgato 4KX capture card. And in the meantime, go watch this video here on that television. We'll see you in the next video.